In this illustration, we'll analyze a case of sand spilling on a flat car. Here the figure shows a fixed hooper through which sand spills on a flat railroad car at a constant rate of r kilogram per second. The car is pulled on a smooth surface by a constant force F. And it is saying if car mass is m0, we are required to find the time function of velocity and acceleration of car. So, in such cases of mass variation, we have discussed that the best way to solve such problem is to apply impulse momentum equation at an intermediate time t and t plus dt, which we have analyzed in detail in concept videos, and here in this illustration we do the same. Say at any time t, the mass of the system is m, which is moving at a velocity v and being pulled with a force F. And at time t plus dt, the mass of the system changes to m plus dm and its velocity increases to v plus dv due to the applied force F on it. Here we can write the value of m is equals to m0 plus rt because the sand is spilling at a rate of r kg per second. So at time t, the total mass of this cart would be m0 plus rt. And here we can write dm is the mass of sand falling on this cart and time dt, which can be written as rdt. So if we use, we can write using impulse momentum equation. Here we can write the initial momentum of system was mv plus the impulse imparted by the forces fdt is equals to the final momentum as m plus dm multiplied by v plus dv. Now, if you open this equation, it gives mv plus fdt is equals to mv plus dmv plus mdv. We can neglect the product of elemental quantities and here also mv gets cancelled out. So, rearranging these terms, here dm can be written as rdt and m can be written as m0 plus rt. So, here we can see this relation gives us F minus RV dt is equals to M0 plus RT multiplied by dV. So, further we can write dV upon F minus RV is equals to dt upon M0 plus RT. And if we integrate these two sides of equality, then we can write the limits also at t equals to 0. The speed of cart was 0 and at a general time t, speed increases to v. Then on integrating, this gives us minus 1 by r. This is ln of, if we substitute the limits also, this will be f minus rv divided by f. Then on the right hand side, it will be 1 by r ln of this m0 plus rt by m0. I've also substituted the limits here. R gets cancelled out. And if we continue here, you can see the values. This negative sign can be taken inside over this logarithmic function. So this becomes F upon F minus RV is equals to M0 plus RT by M0. On cross multiplying these functions, this gives us FM0 is equals to FM0 plus FRT plus, this becomes minus M0 RV minus R square VT. So here fm0 gets cancelled out and in this term 1r also gets cancelled out. So the final value of velocity of cart we can get as a function of time is ft divided by m0 plus rt. So this is one result of the problem, the velocity as a function of time for the cart and acceleration of this car can be given as dv by dt. If you differentiate it by using quotient rule, we can write in denominator square, which is m naught plus rt whole square, and in numerator we can use m naught plus rt multiplied by differentiation of numerator, which is f minus ft multiplied by differentiation of this denominator, which is r. So here this rtf ftr gets cancelled out. The result we are getting is m naught f divided by m naught plus rt whole square. This is another answer for the problem, the acceleration of car.